Hello friends, good morning. Friends, today we will be talking of support and resistances, and basically this support and resistance, this is actually part 2. Why friends I say part 2? Because you know last time in I think video 297, we had given the support and resistances for the trending prices, and today we will talk of the horizontal prices. Okay, friends, now as far as the support and resistances are concerned, the first of all, let us see that what is a support and what is a resistance. Friends, support and resistance actually is a predetermined level which is predetermined of this, where the prices either pause or take the trend reversal. Fine. So now if you see, supposing we are here, the predetermined prices are this, where actually the prices have taken pause and there was a reversal in the price. Okay. Similarly, you know, we see at these prices, say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, five times actually it has taken a support before it actually broke down. Fine. So the prices will either go up or the prices will come down. Support and prices basically are the levels where there is a probability of price either going up, breaking up, or it is breaking down. Now what happens at the resistance level? At resistance level, actually the buyers think the price is too high, therefore the buyers are less, that means the demand is less and the supply comes, that the sellers are willing to sell the product at a lower price. At the lower price, at these prices, friends, what happens is the buyers think that the prices is sufficiently low, below this the prices will not go, and lot of buyers come and then prices actually start rising. So here there is a demand in the price. So support and resistance is nothing but the supply and demand of a share or of a commodity or of forex or anything in the share market. Friends, I want to tell you is that the support and resistance is actually the horsepower of the trading. The better you understand it, more you will find your profits, because the moment here there is a pause, there can be a trend reversal or there can be a breakout. So this is what exactly it is, and use of support and resistances, basically we are trying to identify whether the price is right to buy or not, or the price is right to sell or not. Then how to draw the support and resistances, friends? You know, this we have already seen that, you know, this is actually a line chart, which is my favorite, because here the support and resistances are quite accurate. Otherwise, friends, you can also draw the same thing, you know, on the candlestick charts also. Fine. Now these are actually the support prices, you know, twice it has taken support here, and this is actually the resistance price. You know, in this price what happens is you have to take care of the wick, the highest point of the support price. So this is actually your support price in a horizontal, what we have shown here. Okay. Now my preference is actually the line chart, and this is always a zone, not that this is a straight line. But maybe say about if it is 100 rupees is the price, it could be 101 or 102 up or 98 down. What is the best indicator, friends? We have already seen the best indicator, which nobody mentions, is that either it is the moving averages. Plus MACD. Both are very ideal, you know, for the best indicator which are suited for the support and resistances. Friends, you know, we have already seen in the past also, in my videos also, that you know we don't depend on the one indicator, we depend on the two indicators and sometimes even three indicators. Okay, now the best indicator suits is the moving average and MACD. Then what is the time frame? It works for all the time frames. It works for all the time frame, whether it is 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour, 1 day, etc. But friends, you know, if you want to earn the money, the untold story here is that you should have either the 30 minute candle or you should have 1 hour candle, whether even if it is intraday. If it is a positional trade, friends, in that case you have to consider 1 day candle. But in intraday, so if you take 5 minutes candle, first of all, the 5 minutes candle has no standing of its own, number one. And second is, your trades will be very frequent. If you take 10 minutes candle or 15 minutes candle, some people recommend it, 15 minutes candle. I also, if the stock is very volatile, I also take 15 minute candle. But 30 minute candle is very strong. Your profits will be very large. 1 hour will be still stronger. Now, your point is here is, whether I am right or not, I say I am wrong. What you need to do is go to your software, put there 30 minute and 1 hour candle side by side with moving average of 3 and 8 and see the difference for yourself. I don't have to tell you anything. You will say that yes, 30 minute candles gives more profit. 1 hour candle gives definitely more profit. This is up to you. But if the stock is highly volatile, then of course we say that 15 minutes candle could be okay. But this is only that how you should, how mentally you fit into the, what is your trading psychology. I use 15 minutes candle if it is very volatile, generally half an hour for intraday and sometime even 1 hour. 1 hour means what? There will be 6 candles in a day, 6.5 candles in a day. Maybe intraday may not be possible sometime, but then intraday come positional trade is first class. It gives you definitely more profits. Now, trading can be done with intraday, swing, positional, any kind of trading can be done in support and resistances. And the segments here could be FNO, cash, FNO, commodity. It could be any, cash means equity. Okay, now friends, this is actually today we have completed, you know, as far as the support and resistances are concerned. And to summarize, I will say, if I were to summarize part 1 and part 2, I will say, friends, that as far as the support and resistance are concerned, support and resistance can be in the trending market, can be in the market when it is sideways. At the level of resistance, generally the supply comes. You sell, tend to sell. But supposing, you know, what had happened, if say for example here the supply, the demand was not, the demand had come, so it would have gone up, fine. And maybe that if it had gone up, there was still a demand, then what will happen is here it will be a buy. So this is actually only an indication. It does not give you buy and sell price. The buying is below the support line, selling is below the support line, and buying is above the resistance line. Again, this is something which is very untold. Then we have seen how to draw the lines. The minimum have to be 2. If it is 2, I call it the minor support. If it is 3, it is major support. And if it is more than 3, 4, 5, it is a very, very strong support. It is difficult to break the support, or for that matter, even the resistance. And then best indicators, moving average and MACD, I have said, and all these things, friends, I have already explained to you. I am sure that you will learn this horsepower support and resistance and make money, because without understanding of this support and resistance, it is impossible, you know, to have the entry or the exit point. Friends, the same thing, you know, now we will go and see on the real market also. So be with me. Thank you very much. Hello friends, now we see the support and resistances when the market actually is moving sideways. Friends, you can see we are at 5 o'clock on 11th December here,
And if you really see, this is actually the support line. From here, this support line, it went once up, two, and three mildly up. And here also, it actually, this broke actually the support and went up. And this is the resistance, 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, this is 4, 5, this is intraday actually which is going on. So you can very clearly see that in the line charts. So this is the resistance, this is the support. Now actually it has broken the support here. So it has broken the support here. So here it will be a buy till we see that further fall, or we will see what happens. Fine. And as you can see here, this was earlier support here. It went up, it came down, and eventually it found support somewhere around here. So this is actually the support where when the chart is of 15 minutes and in the line chart. And now we friends see, this is actually the candlestick chart here. You can see the support around, see cursor is here. See, you can see support around here. It is touching the wick here. So this is around somewhere around 9.17, and this is around say 9.37 is the resistance. So thrice actually intraday, you know, this has taken support here, and now the market has closed. Let's see tomorrow actually what happens. And incidentally, you know, you will find, you know, that even with this, there is not much of difference between whether you take the line chart or you take the candlestick chart. Here also support is around say, it is coming around 924, and here it is 935. Not much of the difference. The difference here is coming because of the wick, number one. And now friends, let us check here. You know, I was telling you that more money is where, the more money is where when you have the larger candlestick, isn't so? So now let us just check it out here. This is actually, I have taken off IndusInd Bank today. And in the last leg, you know, what had happened was it has given a buy signal with the, this green line is actually the price line. And yellow one actually is the moving average of 3, and white is the moving average of 8. Fine. So 3 and 8 has given cross somewhere here, and this is at 322. That means 922 rupees it has given a cross. And the selling price it has given is 924. That means with 5 minutes candle, it has given the trader only 2 rupees. Isn't so? Now the same thing actually IndusInd Bank is here also, and this is with a half an hour candle. In half an hour candle, friend, you will see here the buying price is coming at 911, and the selling price is coming here at 927. So that means in half an hour, it has given almost about say 27 minus 11, that means 16 rupees. So if you take 5 minutes candle, the trader will get 2 rupees. If you keep half an hour candle, the trader will get 16 rupees. So if you can, similarly, if you keep 1 hour candle, the trader will still get about another 25 rupees more. So friends, in the intraday trading, it is not advisable to keep 5 rupees candle. Rather, it is more advisable to keep the little larger candle. The minimum candle one must keep, according to me, is somewhere around 15 minutes candle or 30 minutes candle. Now incidentally, you know, let us check here the support also. I will remove all the studies from here so that we can have a clear cut support. And as we were discussing about the support, friends, the support is coming. See how beautifully the support is coming somewhere around this point. You can say the support is coming at 909. Fine. And the resistance actually is somewhere around, you can see between the zone actually is this and this zone. That means it is, the zone here actually is somewhere around 932 and 930. So 2 rupees actually is a difference. This is the resistance. And this is actually the support zone. If you still want, you can take the support zone also here. This support zone is 911 and this is 900. So 2 rupees here and 2-3 rupees here. These are actually the support zones. When here you actually will sell, because it is falling down. No, sorry. Here actually you will take a buy position. It is going up. and support is always a buy position, and just keep the position going up. If it breaks, gives a breakout. Breakout means a big candle. Otherwise, you know, the at resistance there is a sell. So buy here, sell here until there is a breakout here or it is a breakdown here. So friends, that is all actually I wanted to tell you. I hope you have really understood the game, and I really wish that you keep 15 minutes candle or 30 minutes candle. That will give you, 30 minutes candle will certainly give you more money than 5 minutes candle. Friends, thank you very much. Remain with me, and I am telling you the facts. These are the facts which I cannot change. They are actually on the computer or as of 11th of December. So everything is okay, everything is true. Thank you very much.